Le changement climatique changes result from interactions between human systems and Earth systems. This graph from the fourth IPCC report, the Intergovernmental Panel 1987, shows all of the interactions. Typically, if we start from the bottom, we have the socioeconomic development at the origin of the climate change issue, with new technologies developing, consumption, production, more greenhouse effect gases are emitted, which leads to changes in the atmosphere concentration of gases and aerosols. This is obviously linked with our energy consumption, the way we consume and use fossil energies, and the agriculture and industry are key factors. Now, the various changes induce climate changes, changes in the temperature, rainfall, sea level rises, and extreme events like heavy rainfall, and all the risks associated with climate changes. Climate changes also have incidences on a number of other components of the Earth system, such as ecosystems, water resources, and also an impact on health, housing, societies, food safety. And the various impacts, in turn, have consequences on the socioeconomic development, and the loop is closed. Now, if one wants to understand the system, one should develop interdisciplinary approaches, bringing together several disciplines for an in-depth study, which will allow to understand the social dimension, the impact, the green box, and the climate dimension, the blue box. For adjustment purposes, for instance, one method relies in the greening of towns as one way to adjust, but this means we have to understand phenomena such as urban heat islands and the way ecosystems function in town, and we also need to understand how nature in town is seen by society. Another example, health, economy, transportation, carry pathogens to places where they don't belong, normally where they should not be developed, but because of climate changes, these pathogens will find themselves in an environment that will encourage their development, and there will be consequences on human health and new infectious diseases develop. So all of these elements have to be taken into consideration altogether, and it means that we need to develop a dialogue between the various disciplines. We need to develop mutual trust between the disciplines, people working in various fields, different experts. This takes time, but it is a very important part of the problem. Now, facing the climate changes, there are two policies that we can adopt on both sides of society. On the one hand, mitigation, the idea being to limit and mitigate the emissions and the greenhouse effect gas emissions, taking the problem at its origin, and adaptation or adjustment, which will limit the impact on society. Both policies, mitigation and adjustment, require a very strong link between the knowledge on the climatic system and the interactions on the left-hand side and society and the socioeconomic development on the right-hand side. International governance is absolutely essential for the reduction of emissions, and this is exactly what will be discussed in December in Paris in the COP21 meeting. Now, for adjustment purposes, if we want to understand, we need to understand climate hazards and their impact, and also the vulnerability of populations and ecosystems, the way they are exposed to the risk, before we can understand all of the risks and dangers. Co-construction with decision makers and the people who use the data are absolutely essential for adjustment, and this is one of the stakes of the international development, the concept of climatic services, so that we can provide the right type of information in order to allow people to adjust. Climatic changes belong to a family of different stakes. For instance, we have biodiversity, human activities. Through the climate change, the human activities have an impact on the ecosystem. For instance, various categories of plants are moving northwards towards the pole, or in the mountains, they are going up at higher altitudes, and the most vulnerable ecosystems can even be destroyed. Corals, for instance, are dying and becoming white simply because the temperature has increased in the ocean, and this destroys the symbiont's capacity to live in symbiosis with the coral and develop photosynthesis within the coral species. However, considering the connection between the human system and the biodiversity, we also have a direct impact of human activities on biodiversity through deforestation, excessive fishing and pollution. The two stakes, climatic change and preservation of biological biodiversity, have both been the subject of the framework convention, UN framework convention on climate changes in the 90s, in the early 90s following the Rio summit. Development, climatic changes tend to exacerbate some dangers for the poorest populations and the most vulnerable ones, because they have trouble having access to food and water, especially in regions when there is already a water shortage. Also, sea level rising is causing problems in coastal areas, often very populated areas. And one important stake, one important consequence in the matter of climatic change will be to integrate mitigation, adjustment and social objectives so that development can be encouraged. Let us take, for example, the possibilities of co-benefits, mutual benefits, and this is what we need to develop, and this is where we need to take measures, because by improving the quality of air, for instance, we improve quality of life, we reduce pollution problems, and we reduce the sources of greenhouse effect gas emissions. In some areas, agriculture must be developed, trees must be grown in order to mitigate carbon emission and to solve some food problems. Some of the co-benefits are a possibility, and although climatic changes have in their wake a large number of dangers and risks for some societies and for some ecosystems, it is also an opportunity to shed a different light on these problems, which are really matter for the future of humankind.